The following is brought to you by Element 14, the electronic design community where you can connect and collaborate with top engineers from around the world. Join now at element14.com.
Recently, I had the possibility to add a long 145 neopixel LEDs, perfect to create some scenic effects to the back of the scary mirror. To drive neopixels without problems and avoiding to charge of another task the Raspberry Pi, I decided to adopt an Arduino board to control the LEDs. This choice introduced another couple of new problems solved by means of a simple circuit and some discrete components. But sure, the effect of the NeoPixel strip sounds very promising. Including these two new components, the Arduino and the NeoPixel LED strips I have added to the project, let me show how the scary mirror design will be. It is not difficult to connect the Arduino to the Raspberry Pi throughout the I2C protocol. The same problem arose instead connecting the Arduino and the NeoPixels related to the powering of the two devices. The scary mirror should be battery operated. The small audio amplifier for the speakers has its sound 3 AA 1.5 volt batteries. The Pi Juice shield will power the Raspberry Pi and the screen as well as the Pi camera. In order to power the Arduino and the NeoPixel strip, I had to find another solution. The 144 NeoPixel strip requires a considerable amount of power. Why not use one of the 5500 milliampere power banks that lies in the lab. As I tried to connect a power bank like this to an Arduino, after about 10 seconds the battery stopped working. It was very strange, considering that this power bank was able to fully recharge my smartphone about 3 times. Doing more tests, I have also verified that this happens with almost all the battery pack that normally power perfectly any kind of smartphones or tablet. The reason is that the battery includes a circuit controlling when the current request by the charging device ends as it is fully charged. The Arduino board does not interact with the power bank in the same way as a smartphone usually do, so I had to find a solution. With a few discrete components and an unused digital pin of the Arduino GPIO, I set up the sketch to generate a current peak of a few milliseconds every 5 seconds. This event does not impact too much on the performances of the board, but it is sufficient to keep the battery always powered on without difficulty. Before making the back of the mirror and fitting the components inside, I prepared the plastic frame in order to host the PIR sensor and the two speakers with the help of my inseparable hot glue gun. I obtained the interior of the mirror from a couple of pieces of 5 cm thick cardboard plates. The same cardboard block keeps everything in place and constitutes the interior of the scary mirror. The Raspberry Pi, the screen, the two-way mirror, the Arduino, the Pi camera and the Omron Vision camera together. Before proceeding to the components assembly, I black painted the mirror frame with spray paint. The cardboard block inside the mirror helps to keep the NeoPixel strip in place around the internal border of the frame embedded in a cardboard rail. That's all we have for today. What do you think about the solution of powering the Arduino and NeoPixel with the power bank and the circuit presented in this episode. Don't forget to leave your comments on element14.com/presents. We'll see next episode.